Hello, it's the Funny White Man Show. We are bringing nothing but the best straight out of Africa. I am the Funny White Man, and wherever you are, we have loads of exciting stuff lined up just for you. And my first guest on the show today is a very funny comedian. He's going to be coming on a little bit later. But first, one topic catched my attention this week, and that is actually the first casting in Nigeria. I believe that every first casting we've experienced has been a back-to-back hit, I can tell you, because the level of queuing in Nigeria now, only God can determine it. Well, I'm just joking. I would love your opinion about this particular topic. How can we solve it? Because Nigeria is a country blessed with human and natural resources, but even like I say, the humans, when they come, many pass natural resources, but how can we solve fuel scarcity in Nigeria? I love your opinion, and you can do that via our social media platforms. On Facebook, it's / The Funny White Man Show, and you can see the rest on the screen. And I also want to wish Lolo One of Wazobia a happy birthday. We love you here, right here at The Funny White Man Show. We'll go on a break now. We'll come back. We'll meet our amazing guests. Don't go away. Hello, you're welcome. You're watching The Funny White Man Show, which is the biggest, the brightest, and the most entertaining show in Africa.
Funny White Man, Funny White Man, Funny White Man, but this way you talk, you're too much. Give me 5,000 man, that's you. Too much. So you get it, like, make sure
you move along the street. Ah, yeah, make sure that they are going girl. You know, my own people. Ah, actually. Yeah, fine, it's fun. I enjoy it. And I'm one of those very few. I'm forever taking it personal. I will listen 160 million Nigerians are corrupt. How? I thought I'm looking for it.
Yeah, but it's a growth, and this is the time to build business. I know the pitfalls, I know what to do and what not to do. But there are months where you get business and months.
You know how we do, how we turn up. We do the way they do.
Hello, you welcome. You watching Trending Matters on The Funny White Man Show. Of course, we will bring you trending issues just to entertain and tickle your fancy. Show, my first guest on the show today is a very friendly comedian. Please welcome Ken Black.
Thank you very much.
The big boss.
It's a funny white man. He said, finally good to meet you.
Yeah. How's this been so far? Congratulations on everything.
Yeah, thank you very much. It's been going all the way, shall we? Just been moving it. The first scarcity and everything.
Are you serious?
Yeah, it's been crazy, man.
How are you doing, enjoying yourself?
I think that the change has finally come.
Yeah.
Because the change, they really changed the change for us. And then people now start to queue. You queue in church, you queue in mosque, you queue in school, you everywhere is now queue. Who's in your bedroom now, you queue. But we thank God, it shows Africans are strong. At least none of us don't die because of the heat. We're not like other people, so we are strong.
For sure. You know, I fell in love with Mad, Making a Difference. Mm-hmm. And that was about 2 years ago.
Yeah.
And when should we expect the next edition?
Okay, Mad is actually a concept where I would like to bring in people just to celebrate the people, the motherless baby homes, just to get money, get the money that people pay to come for the event.
Yeah.
Is what we used to buy food store. We give like almost, we give 50% of what we make for the event.
Okay, because I know you cannot give the 100%.
Yeah, I cannot give the 100%
because you just broke.
Yeah, I just broke, but I broke this country. Yeah. So, I guess, for now, we're still keeping our fingers crossed.
Okay.
Just to get more sponsors for the event.
Yeah, definitely. You know what? Right now, you are one of the rave of the moment. Every show you've done, right from Mad, Alibaba's January 1st, AY Life, Agodai, I think Standing Ovation or something.
London,
MC Abbey's show has been a back-to-back
hit. Has been
and I kind of love your singing voice.
Yes.
I never knew you could sing. I never thought that would be your brand in a way.
Yeah, I've been part of the choir for quite a long time.
Really? How many years now?
Yeah, I can't remember because I joined them the following year they had to kick me out because I couldn't meet up for rehearsals. I was doing other things. I was trying to create jokes of myself and then I learned more from people, my chorus stars I used to sing, so I guess we stay my house is not far from their house. So I usually go to their house, watch musical movies and improve more in my singing. Then I wanted to do comedy. I love comedy. I love making people happy. I love seeing people happy.
Okay.
And I said to myself, okay, what will make me stand out? What will make me different from other comedians? The fact that I can sing and I think I want to do comedy.
Yeah.
I thought of one day, let's just bring these two together. At the beginning, it was like this.
Okay.
But gradually, it came this way.
Okay.
So I was
are you
blending.
Sure you didn't fast and pray to
my
mold
brother
it?
I asked to fast.
I went to
be the jazz. I went to mountain. Okay. I went to mountain of fire. I went to pray. So we're praying. I just asked God for direction, and this is what we have today. Music comedy is what the people know me for.
And you've made a lot of money. The fame is gradually coming
up. Yeah, for the money.
And for all I can see, a big brand will come your way this year.
Amen.
As
amen.
You'll be the ambassador.
It depends on the world company. I cannot be ambassador for Caesars.
for sure. But tell me, you know the insane thing about is that how do you crack a joke? Because I saw you at AY Life, I saw you at MCAB's event, saw you at Alibaba's event. How do you crack a joke just singing to that kind of crowd and they just love it? Because I've cracked a joke to about like four people and they laughed. So I wonder how you crack it to about 2,000 people.
It depends on the creativity in it, because most of the things I do is I try to use a song that is familiar to people, a song that you know. So what, especially a song I love so much.
Okay.
I try to create a joke out of it. I try to create a storyline out of it. I try to make sure there's a freestyle out of it. So in as much as I'm planning a joke, I have a plan B.
Okay.
So if my plan is not working, I have a plan B of, okay, there's a way I can switch the joke to it.
Okay.
So what I go on stage, I see things around me and I just use it as my material. Because at the same time, it's not easy. It's not very, very easy to make Nigerians laugh. We all have our problems. You have your problems, I have my own. So
I have problems right now.
Yeah, okay, we are Nigerians, we have problem. We have problem. So some people don't understand the fact that many people think because I can make people laugh in my area, makes me a comedian. No, you really need to know if you are called. How I do the jokes, I don't even know. But I know the reputation comes from God.
Okay.
So that's just it.
Which leads me to my next question. Everybody now, when see you, if you say, or you just rose to fame all of a sudden, because you post a video online and you get millions of views. Yeah. They don't know say things hard when men start. So why I would love you to share this right now is how did it all start for you generally?
It started for me in 2008, August 9. Okay. It was 9 p.m. I went on stage for the first time. I was making people laugh in my area. I used to do children party and the MC would not show up. And I would say, they used to call me Papa then. Papa, why not go on stage and do something? Because I look like my grandpa.
Okay.
So why not go on stage and do something? I said, no problem. I just go on stage. I'll do the little things I know, play with the kids. And it was fun. And then August 1, the first day in August, somebody walked up to me and he said, Kenny Black. I was like, who is Kenny Black? He said, you are Kenny Black. I said, hey. I said, I don't know. He said, I think you have what it takes to be a comedian. I said, I don't know. He said, no, I'm gonna give you an opportunity to perform at my event.
Wow.
I said, well, and I saw my name on the poster. I was like, Kenny Black. I pasted that poster from my house to the next junction. I will paste it here, remove it, the next morning, start pasting it.
Wow.
And I was nervous because I was going on stage facing people. People's attention were on me. So I said to myself, okay, I could do this. I was on stage, I was shaking and people were laughing. And I thought it was a concept. I was doing my thing. I left the stage and everybody were happy. What do you do? How do you do it? Gradually, I started getting motivation. I started watching comedians. I started watching comedy shows. I would pay to go for comedy shows. I would watch TV shows and I would see where they would say, this event is coming up soon. For inquiries, one short leave. I don't have any sponsor to do. I only have inquiry. Hello, good afternoon. My name is Kenny Black. I want to perform at your event. People say, we already have comedians. Just send me the address. I will go there, I will beg, and I'll perform. And that was how people started recommending me for events. People started seeing me, okay, I think you should go there, you should do this. And this was how I started.
Which is really great. You know, you just spoke about you watching other comedians do their thing. The thing is that I also did that when I was coming up. So who is like that, your comic mentor, that guy that you just say, I would love to be like that guy?
When I started, I saw somebody who was doing something I wanted to do, and that was Julius Agu. He was doing music comedy. He had a band.
Okay.
So I was like, man, this really inspired me. He would crack a joke, he would sing, he would drop a music video, he would drop an audio, he would dance. I was like, man, this is me, man. I could do this, man. I think I can do this. And I started watching more of him, and I learned the music comedy from him. Okay. I learned freestyles from Basket Mau. I watched Basket Mau do, and I learned maturity from Ali Baba.
Wow, that's great. I think every comedian likes Ali Baba because he is a king of comedy, and it's as if, let me just say, he's the demon of comedy in Nigeria.
He's the ancestor.
Yeah, the ancestor of comedy in Nigeria. So everybody looks up to him. And just before you go, Kenny Black, what is in the pipeline for you right now? Because you are hot, you are doing the shows, you are making the money. What should the fans expect from you?
Yes, presently, I'm doing Kenny Black's Fans Hangout, where I bring people together, just my fans on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram. Let's come together. They want to see Kenny Black. Fine. Okay, let's come together. You get invited. You come to the venue. We take pictures. We talk. You get one-on-one questions with me. You want to ask me anything apart from my age, because I need my management to bring a press conference, just like Kiss Danny is doing, because he can't tell his age. So, I'm bringing people together, and just come together and do stuff. And I'm also dropping my electric package soon.
Electric,
but that's my EP.
Okay.
She knows what I'm talking about. So I'm dropping my electric package. I don't know if any comedian has done this, but I think if I am the first person to do this, I think it's a privilege. The first comedian to drop an EP, it's gonna be something out of the box. Your favorite songs are not getting more interesting. Yet the remix, yet my version. We're coming up. We're hitting the screen soon. Love you all. I'm getting married when God says that's your wife.
Okay. that's nice. I wish you all the best with that. But
thank you very
if
much.
I could ask for this favor, our fans on Facebook and all our social media platforms say they would love you to do something for them. Please, in like 30 seconds, just do something for the fans, please.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Kenny Black. I don't know why we all sing different songs. We all sing different songs, and people are singing songs all the way. But my Igbo people in the house, please do not sing a song you don't know. If you don't know it, just keep quiet. Somebody sang a song, Don Jazzy signs, the Igbo people point it and gave it as a testimony. Yeah, Don Jazzy signs, small boy, small boy, some big man. Oluwani, you don't see Oluwani, daddy, Oluwani, you don't see Oluwani. After the reggae, play the blues, chineke. Make you do it, make you do as I do. Oh, your ma, enjoy yourself, make it groove. Funny white man, even your boo get a boo.
I reject it in the name of Jesus.
Yeah, even your boo gone, if you're jolly boo, and I need to have a boo.
Well, Kenny Black, it's been so nice having you on the show.
Thank you very much.
I respect what you stand for. Wish you all the best. And until next time, man.
Thank you very much, Funny White Man, for having me. The funny black man is here.
No. Until next time, man. You got to drop something before you come out. Okay. You got to drop your Jeep before you go back. As it tights to get that endorsement.
Do you have POS here?
Jeep, you know me want. That your Jeep.
That my Jeep way outside. Do I know I can give you the car when there's four, you give me back.
Well, viewers, I hope you enjoyed Kenny Black. We'll go on a break now. When we come back, we'll be treating some trending issues. Do not go away. Hello, you're welcome. You're watching the Funny White Man Show, which is the biggest, the brightest, and the most entertaining show in Africa.
Funny white man, but this is where you talk, you're too much. Give me 5,000 man, that's you. Too much. So you get it, like, make sure you
move along the street. Ah, yeah, make sure like that I'm going girl. No, my own people, actually. Yeah, fine, it's fun. I enjoy it. And I'm one of those very few.
I'm forever taking it personal. I will listen 160 million Nigerians are corrupt. How? I brother, I'm looking for it.
Yeah, but it's a growth, and this is the time to build business. I know the pitfalls, I know what to do and what not to do. But there are months where you get business and months.
You know how we do, how we train them. We do the way you do.
Hello, you welcome. You watching Trending Matters on the Funny White Man Show. Of course, we will bring you trending issues just 20 days and tickle your fancy. Come back. It's Trending Matters on the Funny White Man Show. And I have two hilarious comedians in the studio right now. Please welcome T Classic and MC Ecclesiastic. What's the pronounce that way, Sha?
You try.
I think it's not guy. You're looking fresh. The only fine boy comedian.
Bro, smile your face with your look.
Like no, catfish is fresh.
Change all, change everything for boys, body. You know.
Really?
I swear.
As in, change things for your body, internal or external?
Everything, even pocket wise.
I understand, I understand. The ministry is moving, just, you know, you just need to fast and pray. Yes. You know, recently this guy died, Prince, that popular musician that everybody loved. And so for the funeral now, the burial, instead of the sister to the cry, she did smile. And sources close to the family say she's supposed to inherit about $800 million. Guy, no, just imagine that one. Is your father late or your father is alive?
My father is late.
Okay, just imagine your father die, you'll be the only picking.
Bro, so my Pima die. Even though still I only shirt and trouser he leave for me, bro. Smile don't like for you. I no cry.
I no cry.
My other brother didn't really cry. Me, I just look. I say this man. So you just die shirt and trouser that he leave for us. So can't imagine say he leave like 50 million, more leave the 850 million. Yeah. I swear, I'm not going to just laugh.
Yeah.
I'm going to roll for grand. They dance.
No, it's actually funny. No, normally everybody they expect and say, me, she cry. But she did smile. She was she didn't want to cry. Let people thank you for coming. May God bless you for coming.
Bro, it's not, you don't say, no, be she kill you, guy. And be see, yeah, no, be sure. She say, me, no, marry me, no, be king, we go collect this thing. I just said
that. You know, that kind of matana, that kind of barrier, your mind will dead here.
Okay.
The thing where you go, you think for your mind now, make people quick go out. Because if they dead, they calculate. They calculate things where you go use the money. They calculate, don't, for your mind, the thing, don't budget. Don't they do budget.
No, but that's not from the comedy side, Sha. Mm. But if you use that from, maybe she just they happy say the guy don't accomplish so much. You understand?
She feel they happy say at least people know him brother before he die.
No, the guy was worldwide. People say know him worldwide, you understand?
Big, big boy.
A big name, die. Big name.
At least nobody all these people they die, nobody knows say one man come off for head self.
My brother, my prayer for you that you will die a star.
Amen. I know one die poor man before.
You know what die poor man?
God forbid. I reject that for my children.
Yes. But when I joke, I do. So let's say not to
me. I reject that.
I reject that personally.
Well, okay. Now, more leader on our side. No say now change don't come.
Yeah.
And then presenting our minister for power is Babatunde
Fashola.
The man that is known for integrity and a lot of things. But now, relax. For now, what do most Nigerians, they ask, in a minister of power, is it the minister of light or darkness? You understand?
But the way with me, I take Siamo.
Okay.
Him be minister of... If I want greet them.
Yeah.
You know, the darkness is somehow. Because it's the catch us. It's the catch us. But for my area, the light me, I don't understand though. Because they will give us for afternoon, but we don't take our sleep.
at least you still get light. Since he enter power, they share prepaid meter. They constantly circulate the old bill on top of the prepaid meter. Nobody for Ikorodu grip pay NEPA bill again.
Okay, now Ikorodu is.
Now Ikorodu is still. Nobody grip pay NEPA bill. In fact, room for my own house. 2 weeks now, I never get light. I don't grip any praise. So everybody get our darkness with it.
But funny enough, you know, say now we Nigerians, we expected a lot of things. Because we know Fashola say you always deliver.
Mm-hmm.
But over a year now, close to a year now, we never see anything.
Maybe.
Because normally, if we are the state, normally I live at Bagada, you understand? And for one reserve container, me they stay, I had to pay about 2,000 and something before I enter. But now, 5K.
But me,
are we going forward or backward? Bros, and light, not day. Bros,
you know, say.
Nah, me, I trust Fashola.
You trust and say
go. I trust him. He go do something. The guy not sure.
No, I know why you say you trust him. You know, say before we get 5,000, might not need drop to one. You know, at times you know who they do at all. The time you say no power.
Okay.
For plants. So, I believe say. With time, Ingo fees change, but it is say na Lagos State, they don't say na federal work.
It's enough. Normally, when you go this kind of key, lights the day. So, what did they cause that problem when light not the day? Because before he come, lights the day. So, as he gonna come, I say we got to increase, we got to pay more money to produce more power.
For my area, prepaid meter never reach my our side.
Okay.
But as my tactic, we know we get light, but NEPA will still come cut light. they don't want to see it. Then the thing will pay me if you owe any small money. They don't want to see anything like light.
Even you know, it get one time better when NEPA want that time when I see the Delta State when NEPA go bring bill, we not go pay. They will come out our wire, we will fix them back. NEPA will come, collect all our wire, come inside our house, collect all our wire, collect the pole. We will go from on touch, they will call off the
my
touch.
My general self, you reach once today, one year we no gripping NEPA B. My general and I, they carry pipe, they go hanging this thing for
even my, even
once we see them, they come, we use even pole, come out pipe, come out time again.
See, even for my house, even for our door, we also take for our door. We are the light of the world. Tear the light, come.
We'll move forward by God's grace. Definitely, we will move forward.
We just move forward, though.
Yeah, because definitely, I get that belief say Fashola must deliver. But the thing we say the jobs when they give out too much. Only in the Minister of Power. Housing and work.
You don't know where you go start from.
You don't know where you go start from. So
you just be confused.
So I believe say go in go deliver. He just needs to sow a seed into my life, and he will deliver. Well, move on to the last one. You get this guy, one very very nice pastor, who come out with one hilarious list. Say if you are a Christian, you want to make heaven. Definitely, there are some things you shouldn't do. Number one, you should not steal. Number two, you should not play with girls. Number three, you should not dance Shakiti Bobo and some other ones. Yes, guys, is that how you say this one?
This is how they shake it like this. Cause I read.
But
the
no,
list.
But before you talk, you know, say if not truly this is not waiting God won't say me man not do, you go and fire.
I know
only for this room, not only me will go heaven.
I know if now that is the one for I know we'll go heaven.
Now only me go heaven. Who my producer said will go heaven?
I'm not sure say you
said we'll go heaven. I'm gonna wave and say, producer Alpha, Alpha, eh?
Bros, I'm not sure say you will go heaven yourself. So who wait till you talk now? You don't even lie. So I just say everybody when they want go just go and fire. Bros, you don't say you know for that list say you don't go play football.
Yeah.
And I just say you don't play football.
It means you're all the super.
You know, you don't go and fire.
Our God is a merciful God.
But where the guy do mistake for that list? The guy don't say no sugar mommy, no sugar daddy. He just put boyfriend and girlfriend.
Okay.
So meaning say sugar mommy is allowed, sugar daddy is allowed. For those who say they follow people old
no,
person.
No, in our circle here, we don't allow that. It is seen in Nigeria.
In Nigeria. Yes. Okay, well, but yeah. If you tell me they collect my destiny, give me 20 million. That man no come to use the destiny to do anything.
Well, funny enough, this list is really deep funny. You understand? Because for you not to dance to some kind of music, you understand? Like Shakiti Bobo when they known.
No, man. Even even pastor they dance active.
T-class, I believe saying the guy he no chop food before he sleep. Now hungry make a dream that kind of dream. You know that time where you no chop better food sleep. You go just the reasons or kind of stupid stupid.
The way we take the kind eat within Nigeria go make it the thing some kind.
But funny enough, T-class, if you reason waiting this guy talk, the list how you see him on your own personal.
How you see him? To me, some way in talk me I like him.
Okay.
Well, some like some way can say me no play some kind of game because me I don't play the game. Me say me I dey go fight because the guy don't they make me fear now.
Okay.
Like in I say me no cover some kind of calf. So see bros now don't they go.
Okay.
Bro, this is how I say you said they go. You don't go and fire.
Why you say me not the go this one?
The list. No. See if you check the list. Some part of the list. On a normal ground, the Bible self condemns some part of the
list. Yeah, for sure.
But those other ones where they put, like, say, no, see, because even the dressing away, say, woman, no wear trouser. She ain't no say for olden days, for Bible. Now, robe that they wear. Robe now waiting for this present generation. Now, gown now.
Yeah.
Gown, who they wear gown? No, be woman.
Yes, ma'am.
If you go some part, like Scotland, now, men they wear skirts.
Really?
Yeah, they wear skirts there.
You
so,
don't go there before.
And they see their movies, they wear skirts.
Okay.
So if you check them now, ah, you want to know which will be man, know which will be woman. Oh.
For sure.
So most of that thing we did that list over. If I say the guy yours chop, they begin to write anything.
No, na eat, cause
na eat, cause.
If you say na eat, na yeah they eat.
But me, but
like yes, he did. So
but before you come for your son, so beat him for your entire.
But, I don't know. Maybe they bring the vision show him.
Bro, see God no fit be that kind thing for. Even if God revealed that, but God no put saving and no pay mother.
So they told I say you know God mind. He say is it my guy God?
No, see even you want know the kind of way God go feel if you are God go see me you no play mortal combat.
Say the boss. Say me no play football.
Say no play football.
Eh? It means to work. No, if you to play
look
football.
The alcohol, fornication, where they did, yes. Say okay, Bible self condemn this one.
And but, which one? And you don't do that,
but me as bros, now you talk camo.
You don't take alcohol.
No, you know they take alcohol. But
I'm
saying
they work for brewery, okay, so okay, you don't feel expensive. But say they work for brewery, you don't go test.
They test and small, small.
But no, Allah, Shamo, Allah, Shamo, leave him. The guy, wait till the guy talk, actually, it makes sense. Some things when he talks.
Some things make sense. Why some?
So, and I use this opportunity though to tell now when they are there, say, man, if you do bad thing normally, I beg, make you try to stop him. And one more time, I just want Hala on thanks guys for coming on the show now too much and make us laugh today and we wish on our way for the comedy hustle.
Well, God
the
God
next
God
time
God
I will see you, they drive G-Wagon 1960
aye.
Model.
No, I reject that.
I go drive and dash it.
Well guys, we've come to the end of the Funny White Man show. Before we go come out, you get this guy for Facebook when all they holler us, and I want to give a very big thank you to Temilein Duro Sae, thank you for your support, thank you for your encouragement, and till we meet on our next week, we love you and remember to laugh. Bye bye.